Hey, it's John from Dorian Charm. So we'll talk to you today about kind of a weird subject, and that's bird feeders. And I'm going to try a little do-it-yourself project. This bird feeder you're looking at right here is the best one I've ever owned. I haven't been able to locate another one, or I'd buy some more. But my problem has been not the birds, but the wildlife that take the bird feeder from the birds. Squirrels, of course, are a constant problem, and that's the case in a lot of different areas. In my area, I have two other problems. One is deer, which if this bird feeder isn't located, you know, 6 or 7 feet above the ground, then they will reach up on their hind legs and just knock it down, believe it or not, to get at the bird seed. And the other problem I have is raccoons, and they have been my worst enemy. There'll be 3 or 4 at a time. They'll come at night, and they'll sit on top of the bird feeder and just spin around on the thing until the wire breaks up here, or they're able, with the weight of their bodies, just to knock the whole thing down to the ground, and then they have a feast on the bird seed. So I've had some issues. So this is the best one I've had, but I just can't get another one, and it's pretty well destroyed at this point. So I got thinking to myself, there must be some way to do this myself, and cheaply, because most of these bird feeders that are any good are extremely expensive now, like $80, $100, $120. Are you kidding me? I'm just trying to feed some birds. So I thought to myself, there must be a way of doing this, and I got some materials here, which I'll talk to you about, and I'm going to give it a try and see if I can make this work. So the first thing I bought was this bird feeder itself, which is fine for what it is, but this would not last very long in my place. So what I like about this is it's a large tube, it's see-through, you can put the bird seed in the top here, and it has perches for the birds. My old bird feeder also had perches, but they came out pretty easily. They were made of just a thin metal, and these little tabs right here would be what locks them in place, and the raccoons would reach in and just yank them out, and then the bird seed would spill all over the place. So those didn't work out very good. This bird feeder, by contrast, has these more robust perches, and they screw in there in the middle there. I don't know if you can see that screw or that nut there. There it is. And so I think that would be a little more sturdy. But it needs protection because this is not going to last. So this I got at Walmart for $10. So I figure for $10 I can't go too far wrong. So I got a way to feed them and to hold the bird seed. Now I need a way to protect that tube. So I got thinking, you know, I could just use wire mesh. They call it hardware cloth, but basically it's, you know, it's like a mini fencing. Now this particular one that I got, I paid $12 for. It's only half inch as far as the squares. So you see the grid there, the squares are only half inch. Now that's way too small, obviously, for birds. But what I can do is just cut out some of the squares big enough that I can allow birds in, but that will keep out the squirrels and the raccoons. So I got that, and I figured I'd be able to wrap it around this existing bird feeder somehow. Next thing I looked at was this. Now this is a specialized product. It's made by Simpson. I got this at Home Depot, or Home Cheapo as I like to call it. And the number is LTB20. And what this is meant for is bridging on joists, on floor joists. It's meant to help, you know, keep them stable. And so it's used in new construction. But I think I can use these instead as upright posts. They're about the right height as my bird feeder. And if I had a top and a bottom, I could use these as posts that would help sturdy the thing up and maybe provide a place where I could attach this this fencing to. And the last thing I would need would be a top and a bottom. I thought about using a bucket, like the top of the bucket and the bottom of a bucket, but I don't think that's going to be sturdy enough for what I'm trying to do. So my next two options were either some scrap wood, which I do have lots of actually, but that won't last that long out in the weather. Eventually it'll crack and become a problem. Or I could use this, which is PVC. And there's different brands of this. I tried a couple of test staples, and you can staple into it. So I think this might be my answer. It's plastic. It's not going to rot. It has enough strength for what I'm doing. It's not that heavy. And I think I'd be able to cut this into, you know, the shape that I need and make it work. So if you don't have access to this, you can buy it at Home Cheapo. Wood is fine as well. But you need something for a top and a bottom. So I'm going to try this stuff and see where we go. And the last thing I got was some swivel eye bolts, because I want to be able to attach the bird feeder to the tree, but have it turn around so that the wire that I attach it to doesn't become all twisted up, which is what the raccoons like to do to bring the whole bird's feeder down to the ground. All right, it looks about 9 inches is a good number for the overall diameter. So I'm just going to mark a 9-inch circle on here. And that works out pretty well, because if you buy a 1x10, you know, it'll be a little bit more than 9-inch, so you'll have enough room to do that. And I'll make another circle down the other end here, and then we'll have a top and a bottom. All right, I have my two circles for the top and bottom now. And on the bottom, I thought this is just a flat surface here. So when I put this new bird feeder on top of it, I don't want it to just be sliding around like that. I'd like to try to be able to center it and just keep it sturdy a little bit. So I noticed that a hole saw, in this case it's a 4 1/8 hole saw, looks about the right size. So what I'm going to do is take this hole saw and just relieve a little bit of the area here. I'm not going to go all the way through, and that should be enough so that when I put this bird feeder on there, I'll just keep it steady. So all right, so I got my top, my bottom. My bottom, I ended up adding a little block right here, which fits inside. See right here? There's a hollow area there. This is actually meant to be put on a pole or something like that. So I have a little block here I glued on there. So I probably didn't have to do that circle after all, but whatever. And then the top, I cut the hole completely through. And the idea is I'm going to have this come through something about that high, and that'll allow me to get to the top of the bird feeder but protect the rest of it. So the next step then is, if I can find them here, where did I put them? These little, this bridging is what it's meant for, but I'm going to use it to connect the top and the bottom. And I am going to, I think, bend, because this is meant to be bent anyway, bend this underneath and then screw it into place. So I'll do that next. I'll use, I don't know, 4, maybe 6 of those. And then we'll make sure this fits correctly. And then it's a matter of wrapping that wire around the whole shebang. All right, so I take these and I bend them 90 degrees. Now that'll hook under and over the top and the bottom. And then I'm just gonna use half-inch screws with a nice head on it to secure those. All right, I've attached these posts, I'm gonna call them, and it's just screwed into the bottom here, nothing fancy. I didn't even measure, you know, the distance. I mean, I just eyeballed it. It's a bird feeder, it's not a china cabinet. So we have those in place now, and they are somewhat flexible, so you can bend them around if you need to. And the top's just sitting here right now. So now, if I find it here, I'll just attach the top, and I'll screw up here through into the top. Before I do that, I want to also take a look at the attachment of the whole bird feeder when it's done to the tree. So I think what I'm going to do is just drill a hole here and another one over here, and then put some washers or something underneath with just some wire, and it'll just be as simple as that. So I'll have a wire loop coming around here over the top of the opening. All right, to attach the wire, probably cable would be better, but all I had with me was wire, so I can replace it at some later date. But wire or cable, because otherwise the squirrels will chew through it and the whole thing will drop. So on this side, I just put a large fender washer and just a small washer with the wire looped under the washer, so when that pulls tight, that won't go anywhere. Okay, now you can see the frame all together. So I have them screwed into the top. I have my wire up here. And to install the bird feeder, I can just slip it in like that and seat it at the bottom here. Find the middle for this. All right, so that's what it looks like. And at the top here, there's enough room where I can get the original top off, I can also pick the whole thing up. Now the squirrels won't be able to do that, nor will the raccoons, I don't think. But it's protected. Now, the last thing to do is to put this wire cage around it. So now I have a frame, I can wrap the wire cage around it, I can staple into the edge here or the bottom. I can wrap with wire ties or wire itself onto the posts. I have something to tie to. So I'll wrap this cage around it first, and then I'll look to where I want to put the holes for the birds to get in. Oh, and before I forget, which I already did, you could paint these posts if you want now. You'll want to take the bird feeder itself out so you don't spray that. But with that out of the way, you can paint this any color you want. All right, so I'm just wrapping this wire cage around here, this fencing, whatever it is. And then what I did was cut out every third one, right? And then you can just bend it over with your hand and staple it. I am using, by the way, stainless steel staples so they won't rust on me. But, you know, it's enough to hold it in place, and it's easily reversible, so in the future I can repair this thing if I need to. So I've done the bottom, and this also adds some structure in addition to the posts that I have. And then, tilt this thing up. What I can do is wrap some wire around the posts, maybe at, you know, two or three different spots up here. That'll add some strength. And then I can, on the top here, I could choose to do two things. One, I could just leave it like it is, but I think I'm going to bend it over like I did the bottom and staple that just to give it a little more strength. And then we'll be pretty well done. So let me finish doing that. And then the last thing to do will be to cut some of this grid out so that the birds have a place to go in to eat. All right, so we're all done here as far as that. We got the fencing installed here, everything stapled in on the top and bent over. You can bend it over with your fingers, it bends easily. And then I used the wire that is wrapped around the outside of this stuff when you buy it. It's left over, so I unwrapped that and reused it to tie it off on each post in several places. So that's all good shape. So the last thing to do is to cut the holes for the birds to get in to do the feeding. So obviously we're gonna cut the holes around the area of the little perches inside there, but the question is, how big should the hole be? Well, if I go over to my commercial bird feeder here, these holes, which work fine, they're about not quite 1.5 inches wide and about 1 7/8 tall. So if I do something in that range, I think I'll be fine. Let me grab my tape measure here. If I come over here, let's see, how does it work out? So 1.5, if I did 1.5 by 1.5, that should be fine. So I'll probably do that. To cut the holes, you know, you can use, you know, what I call dikes or diagonal pliers. You can just use wire cutters or shears like this. You can use needle nose pliers, almost anything. This wire cuts very easily. All right, so that's it. I got my holes cut here. I'm not sure if that comes through on camera, but they line up with the bird feeder inside, and that can twist and move if I need it to. I don't think it'll be a problem, but if it does, I can always tie it off. The last thing I want to mention is to get this swivel hook. So this, you know, turns independently of this. So I can put that on my wire up here. Let me get that going. And then I can tie it off like that. And the whole thing, you can see it already, is twisting a little bit. And that'll allow that to move so that if these darn raccoons get on here and start twisting away, it won't break the wire. But all things said, I mean, it's not really unattractive. I mean, yeah, it's not great, but it's not completely unattractive. And I think it'll get the job done, and that's the main thing. All right, one last little update on this bird feeder. So I put it out for a little while just to make sure the birds will use it and get used to it. And the first thing that happened was the chickadees and the tufted titmouse, those type of birds, the small birds, came right up and no problem. They were in there and out there eating the bird seed. The blue jays, the bigger birds like that, which I prefer not to have anyway, basically stayed away. The opening is just too small for them, and they weren't interested. The intermediate birds, like cardinals, did not. They just seem a little reserved about it. So I'd like to try to encourage them to come as well. So what I decided to do was just put a little perch here, and I can do this on all the openings. It's very easy to do, and it's adjustable, so it's easy to move around or just to remove if it doesn't work. But I'm going to give it a try. All I did was take a dowel, and this might be a little bit big, but it happened to be the one I have on hand. I drilled a hole on either end, and I just used copper wire. This is 14 gauge, 14 or 12 gauge would be fine. It's just electrical wire, and any wire would do really. And I just bent it to the shape I wanted, hooked it on the cage here, and that gives a little, perch for them to sit on first. And I'm thinking if they have a little perch, they might be able to more comfortable about reaching in there to get the actual bird seed. So I'll give it a try. If it doesn't work, I can bend it to a different direction, move it out or in or whatever I need to do. And if it doesn't work at all, I can just take it off. But that's another thing to try. But the smaller birds, no problem. They were very happy with it. The intermediate birds, I just feel like they just need a little something there to stand on before they go in.